G'day guys, welcome back to the channel and look at what I have here for review today. It is indeed a Zinn, German watch brand based in Frankfurt, over 50 years established now, and I believe originally founded by a pilot instructor. That's what I understand from the history. Now, this watch has again been made available by my good friend and local supporter Graham, who has made many of his watches available for review. So thank you again to Graham. So out of box and cardboard, inner box embossed here in faux leather, and let's just get into it. So this is the inner box, and then you have some warranty card information in here from, this was bought from Define Watches. Put that aside and just quickly show you the manual, which really has two sides. You know, this one's in German and this side's in English, and it is focused on this specific model, so this specific movement. Nice little pictures here, and then it goes into how to use it, loom shots there, which I will of course also show you off the watch itself. So let's just get into the box here. So, you know, faux cardboard, nice and solid. It's in on the top there, and there is the watch itself. So let's just get this open and out of the box to have a good look at. Okay, so guys, this is the Zinn 104 STSA. Now, I'm not really sure what STSA stands for. I suspect it probably does stand for something. This is the W version, meaning I think white dial, automatic pilot's watch here. So this one was bought from Divine Watches, an Australian retailer, and it kind of lists for 1850 AUD. Previously, I understand it was listed around 1300 USD. So let me know what you can find with regards to retail price of this particular watch. It's not listed on Amazon or Joma Shopman or some of the big online retailers as far as I have seen. The movement in this watch is actually a Sleiter SW220-1. So this one is a 28800 beat per hour movement. You know, it is actually the equivalent of an ETA movement. You know, Sleiter was a subsidiary that ETA used to manufacture a lot of movements in the past, but I believe they are kind of independent now. So 26 jewel mechanism, 40 hour reserve is the rating here. It does have manual winding, it does have hacking, and a day date display, which you can see on this watch is implemented here on the 3 o'clock. A black outline windows there, right? Nicely done, and it flicks over very quickly and nicely actually when the watch hits the 12 hour on the 24 hour mark. It flicks very instantaneously, so that's a nice little touch there. This particular watch is rated to be multi-resistant, so if you look at the back here, right, you've got a water rating there, and then along the sides as well. Right, I'm not going to try to say the German because I don't have any knowledge of German, but that's stainless steel. That's at the top there, shock resistant. And then over here, of course, is anti-magnetic. So the resistances are rated according to DIN standards. DIN is a German institute, a Deutsch Institute, I believe DI actually stands for. So 8308 for shock resistance, meaning that it does have to be hit by a hammer at a certain speed, and its speed and accuracy cannot vary by more than 60 seconds off a day. Magnetic resistance is DIN 8309, and that's equivalent to ISO 764 in my understanding, meaning exposure to a magnetic field of strength 4800 amps per meter will not cause this watch to go off by more than 30 seconds a day. And then also the water resistance is rated towards a DIN 8310, which is equivalent to ISO 2281, meaning it's not tested towards dive standards, and it's not intended to test towards that. It's more towards everyday water resistances and usage. But you know, the quality and construction of this watch, if you look at the window, the back screw-in, screw-in crown, a sapphire display back, I have no hesitation using this in underwater swimming. You know, I guess maybe you will have some doubts using it as a proper dive watch, but I suspect it will easily withstand the rigors of proper scuba diving if you so choose to use that. Okay, so the case here is 41 millimeter in steel, right, stainless steel, 12 millimeters on the thickness, 20 millimeter lug width, which I think is, of course, appropriate for this watch size. And the lug-to-lug is a fairly modest 47 millimeters. Now, the case itself tips the scales at 73 grams, so pretty light. And with leather, it's just around the just above 100 gram mark. If you bought the bracelet, steel bracelet, of course it would go higher than that. But overall, it's a fairly light package. Fully polished, okay, if you look on the surfaces all around, top surface of the case are all fully polished, right? I mean, at the bottom here, under the lugs, you can see it is brushed, and then it's got a nice brush finishing of the case back there. But the top, which is what you see on the wrist, is all polished. There is a screw-in display case back, and I've already mentioned that that glass is actually sapphire crystal. The crown, let's let you have a look at that. Right, it's pretty nicely done, and it's got a nice Zin sign there. So with that combination with the case back, it is 200 meter water rating. Again, ISO 2281 rather than Diver's ISO rating. The dial itself, so let me just zoom in there a bit, right? It's kind of a gloss white, right? It's a gloss white dial, and it's really quite nice. It is printed, right? It doesn't appear to have any applied elements in there, but it's a pretty rich printing, right? Just, you know, let you have a look closely there. The printing is thick. It raises up above the dial, even though it's not applied, you know, any bit of it. And it's just bounces off the dial, you know, it's very distinct as far as I've seen here. The hands are this kind of this vintage syringe style hands, and the lume is of course Super Luminova and works as well as you expect it to. Of course, I will put up a lume shot for you to see how it actually looks in the dark. Now, the bezel is interesting. They call this a pilot's bezel. So if you're a pilot, let me know what you would use this and how you would use this for. So 60 click. All right, and it's dual directional, right? It's bi-directional. It's not a unidirectional dive style bezel, as you can see there. The other interesting thing there is it's actually secured by this little screw. So you're not supposed to just pop this up by friction. It's not held in by friction like many dive watches are. You have to remove the screws to actually loosen the bezel and change the bezel if you were inclined to do that. So that's something a little bit different that not all watches will have. The crystal, dome sapphire with dual anti-reflective coating. And of note is that it's kind of contiguous with the bezel, which is kind of a nice thing, you know. It's like one sweep there, kind of like the Auris Aquastate, which I really enjoy. Going on to the band, well, nothing much to talk about here, right? Zin 20mm band. This is what they call cowhide leather. I'm not a big fan of bands and particularly leather, but this one feels to be of premium quality as far as I can tell, and I'm not by any means an expert on that. Polished steel buckle with the Zin name on the buckle there, of course. Okay, so that's the watch. Guys, what have I enjoyed about this? I think this is a really, really great piece, actually. Yes, it does cost a bit. Costs more than my Auris, but it's really very nicely done. I think it's obviously a very original design, right? It's not copying anybody. Zin is well known for that, right? Being original, a pilot style, which, you know, what do you have in a pilot's watch? Well, in my understanding, super legibility, and certainly this meets that criteria. It is very, very legible in both daylight and night conditions. You have a big crown that you can operate easily, even I think with gloves on. Some pilot watches will have an even bigger crown than that, but this is, you know, this is a relatively big crown, I think. And you know, it's got many quality inclusions, including the triple resistance that we talked about, the shock resistance, water resistance, magnetic resistance, which I understand should be a feature of proper pilot watches. So this one doesn't have the later pilot watch standard, which I understand is DIN 8330, right? They haven't stated that this meets that criteria, but certainly it does have a lot of quality inclusions. You know, it's got the German option to display the date in German language, which is, you know, adds to its charm. And it's got that different style bezel with that screw there. So lots of quality little inclusions. The finishing, I think it oozes quality and, you know, just class. I don't know what it is. You know, they haven't gone for transitions to brushed and polished, but the finishing, I think, is just excellent. There's something about this that you know, when you hold it in your hand, you know there's a level of class and quality here. What's not good about it? Well, I don't think there's much to criticize, really. Honestly, I'm nitpicking if I do. You know, some people have said, well, you know, the movement isn't super. I think it's reasonably pretty, but, you know, it's not an in-house movement. It's a Sellita. So maybe a display back isn't needed. You know, does it introduce a weakness to the watch? Some people would be a bit critical about that, but I don't mind having a display back. The other thing I would say is that the bracelet options are expensive. So this version, $1,850 Australian dollars, if you were to buy the metal bracelet version, you have to add on at least $400. I think it's actually about $470 additional dollars if you get the metal bracelet. So not cheap if you prefer the bracelet. And unfortunately, I'm a person who does. So guys, there we have it. This is the Zin 104 STSA automatic pilot's watch. That's my thoughts on it. Let me know what you think. You know, this brand does appear to have a lot of following, a lot of loyalty, a lot of love among watch fans. I'd like to hear your thoughts on it if you have one, if you have experiences particularly. Guys, if you enjoy my videos, do consider subscribing. I'm putting out new content weekly, always aiming to be objective and unbiased about all things horology. Thank you again for watching, and as always, I will catch you next time.